In this short video, we'll provide a quick demonstration of how agile teams can add BDD scenarios to user stories in Jira using AssertThat. So we'll show you how to link existing BDD scenarios and add new scenarios to user stories in Jira. We'll set the mode of the scenarios to automated or manual. We'll show you how to manually execute the scenarios, and also we'll have a look at how the automated test results can be viewed on the page as well. So we'll assume that you've already installed the plugin, in which case, to view the AssertThat functionality, you need to enable it on a project-by-project basis. So click on Project Settings, click on AssertThat Integration, and then you need to click on the toggle here to enable it. So when you first go onto a Jira user story, you'll need to enable the AssertThat functionality and modules on the page. This is done by clicking on the Acceptance Tests. So we'll start by adding a new scenario. You can add a scenario to a existing or a new feature. We'll add it to an existing one for starters. So just search for the feature that you want to add it to, and then start typing in the scenario name and steps. So you can type in the steps if you want, or you can reuse existing steps using the autocomplete functionality. So type in a few keywords, hit Control and Space or Option Space if you're on a Windows machine, and it will fill in the details. Where you have a lot more scenarios with the key terms, you can then scroll through the ones which you're interested in linking to. And then finally, clicking on save, you can now see you've got your feature, you've got your scenario. You've got options here to unlink it if you choose to, and you also to delete the scenario. You only get the option to delete the scenario if you've newly created the scenario on this page. So what we're going to do now is going to link some existing scenarios. So I'm going to click on select scenario. And now I have to use the filters to find the scenarios I want to select. I can filter using the feature name. I can filter by the tag expression, the scenario tag, or just search for the scenario by name. And then again, I can filter it further using the manual or automated buttons here. Just to show you how to add scenarios using tags, it'll give me a list of all the available tags. I'll select the one I want to choose. Okay, so what we'll do now is we'll show you how to manually execute the scenarios. So there's a really important toggle that I need to show you first, and that's under, again, Project Settings, AssertThat Integration, and here you've got Independent Scenario Execution. So this toggle allows you to set the state of the scenario to be independent for each of the user stories that it's linked to. So you could have a scenario linked to many different user stories or any Jira issue type, and you could have the status, the execution status, set differently for each of those Jira issues. So what we'll do now is we'll click on the manual scenario and we will start to run it. So click on the button here. And then we need to click on the status, so passed, failed, or in progress. And then we can update that one again to be failed. And when we fail the test, we've also got the option to add and link it to an existing defect. As you can see, we've got some automated scenarios on this page. Typical flow would be that the BDD scenarios are hosted within the plugin. You download the scenarios to your test automation framework. The scenarios would be executed there, and the results would be imported back into the plugin. When the scenarios are imported back into the plugin, you'll be able to see the latest status of the results on this page and throughout the reporting that comes with AssertThat. So in the background, I have imported some test results from a test automation framework just to demonstrate how the results are displayed here. So this is an automated test. You can see that the test has actually failed, and I can view the execution history here. I'll click on full details here. It'll take me through to the actual test results, and you can see full details of the failed test here. Okay, we've gone back to the user story again. If you wanted to get a view of all of the status of all the scenarios in here, then using the expand and collapse, you can quite easily see the features, the scenarios, the status on here. We also have a gadget here, which gives you an overall status here. So if you've got many scenarios in here, this is quite useful to seeing the overall status of the scenarios against the user story here. We've used user stories as the example issue type within this demo. However, assert that scenarios can be linked to any Jira issue type. Okay, so if you like this video, please click on the like button or leave a comment. That would be really appreciated. If you do have any questions, then please email us at support@assertthat.com. We'll put details into the video notes regarding how to set up a demo if you'd find that useful. Thanks for watching.